We will begin today's ceremony with the national anthem, sung by Evan Ballinger. Yeah, you might as well stand back up. I could have told you that. Drake Garcia, Jacqueline Hampton, Abigail Sweat, Colleen Sweat, and Colton Strutman.
So proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. Thank you. That was beautiful. I'm Alicia Johnston, president here at Fort Scott Community College, and on behalf of the faculty, staff, and board of trustees, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to our commencement here today at Fort Scott Community College. I would like to take this time to introduce our stage party. So we have Dr. Adam Borth, vice president of academic affairs, Mr. Robert Nelson, Vice Chair, Board of Trustees, Steve Armstrong, Outstanding Alumnus, Janet Fancher, Vice President of Student Services, Dr. Tom Havron, Vice President of Student Affairs and Foundation Director, and then in the back, Dave Elliott, Fort Scott Community College Trustee, Kirk Hart, Fort Scott Community College Trustee, Santos Manrique, Director of the Crawford County Campus, Sonia Guganani, Dean of Instruction and Institutional Effectiveness. We also have our faculty, led today by our emeritus faculty, Kathy Malone and Deborah Cummings. I want to thank you for attending. Thank you to the family, the friends, the faculty, all of those that made it possible for our graduates to be here today. Especially thank you to our graduates. I'm sure that your family probably is very excited about the possibility of you getting a job and moving on, because that's the biggest paycheck they'll ever get. But it really is exciting. And I always get kind of emotional about graduation. It is a new beginning for you, but of course, it is an ending as well. I hope that the time that you have been here will always be with you. I believe that one of the most important things about attending college is that you get to be with people that do not think like you, that do not look like you, that did not walk the same path as you did to get here. And I think that you will find, and hopefully you have already found, that with those people that you have differences, you have a lot more in common than you actually have differences. You know, I encourage you as you go on to think for yourself, but I want you to always give all people and all ideas consideration and respect, not just those that are familiar or comfortable, because that's really part of this process of growing an education. Treasure and apply the education that you have learned here, the skills and the life experiences that you have acquired. Best of luck as you continue on your career path. Try not to forget us if you become rich and famous. We would appreciate that. And my new favorite saying by the great academia, Wayne Gretzky, he says, always skate to where the puck is going to be, not to where the puck is. Best of luck to you. And now Dr. Tom Havron will introduce our outstanding alumnus.
Good afternoon. This is the first time that I've been here that we've had standing room only and two overflows. I absolutely packed. So congratulations to the graduates on having a wonderful sense of support. For that support, congratulations for having a very special group of graduates. It is my privilege to present the 2022 Fort Scott Community College outstanding alumnus, Steve Armstrong. Mr. Armstrong moved to Fort Scott in 1960, where he attended Fort Scott Junior High School and Fort Scott High School. He was active in several sports, but focused on basketball. Mr. Armstrong graduated from Fort Scott in the spring of 1965 and received the Balfour Award during graduation. He entered FSCC as a freshman in the fall of 1965, where he was a member of the Greyhound basketball team for 2 years. He was selected team captain by his teammates for the 66-67 season. He graduated valedictorian in his class in the spring of 1967, where he moved on to continue his education and basketball career down the road at Pittsburgh State University. Again being elected captain by his teammates both years as a Gorilla, Steve graduated from PSU magna cum laude in the spring of 69 with a Bachelor of Science in Education degree. The PSU Education Department presented him with the Outstanding Student in Education Award. Following graduation, Armstrong taught mathematics at the Fort Scott Junior High School for a year before entering the mathematics graduate program at PSU as a grad assistant. He graduated in the spring of 71 with his Master of Science degree in mathematics. Mr. Armstrong married his high school sweetheart, Janet, in May of 1971. They were blessed with two sons, Chris and Jeff. Both of his boys are married, and their family now includes two daughters-in-law, two granddaughters, and four grandsons. During his time in Fort Scott, Armstrong was a member of the Fort Scott Kiwanis Club and served as president during the 1976 Bicentennial Celebration. Throughout the years, he joined other club members in meeting various needs of the community. He served as chairperson of the United Way of Bourbon County, chaired the committees for the community-wide visioning effort, was a member of the First Leadership Kansas class, and is a longtime member of the Community Christian Church. Armstrong had two professional careers in his lifetime. His first career opportunity began in 1972 with the Western Insurance Company here in Fort Scott. He began working in the automobile underwriting department in 1978, was promoted to a position with the company's management team. On April 4th, 1998, Armstrong began his career at FSCC. Initially hired to be the Director of Management Information Systems at the college, his responsibilities were quickly expanded to include the Director of Admissions. In the summer of 1990, he became the President's administrative team and assumed the duties of Dean of Students. This responsibility included several areas across campus, including supervising the Director of Admissions, the Registrar, Financial Aid Director, Academic Advising, Dorm Director, and Director of Management Information Systems. Mr. Armstrong was known as a true advocate of student success during his time at FSCC. During my time as the Vice President of Students, we often encountered many difficult situations which required deliberation on which path to take. Most of the time, when speaking with those who were fortunate enough to work beside Mr. Armstrong, the answer to these questions were, this is how Steve used to do this. More often than not, Steve's direction from the past is the path that we decided to take. His honesty, integrity, and ethical character is still seen in the departments he used to lead. It is a privilege and an honor at this time to name Steve Armstrong as the 2022 Fort Scott Community College Outstanding Alumni.
Thank you, Tom. Greetings, President Johnson, the administrative team, members of the Board of Trustees, faculty and staff, family and friends, and especially the 2022 graduates. We are here today to celebrate your academic achievements. For each of you, this represents the ending of one journey and the beginning of another. I remember the sense of achievement that I had when I successfully completed this important milestone of my post-secondary education. Certainly, the academic lessons you've learned here at FSCC are important and critical for your next journey. However, I'm confident that your lessons learned extended beyond the formal classroom experience. I found the content rigor of my FSCC instructors to be such that it properly prepared me for the academic challenges waiting for me after my FSCC graduation. Beyond that, however, my FSCC experience equipped me in other important and empowering ways. I was challenged to examine myself, to identify my personal strengths and my weaknesses, to build on my strengths, and to work to improve those areas that needed improvement. Our introspective moments, however, are not always easy. I had one of those moments a few months before I entered FSCC for the first time. I played varsity basketball in high school. I was one of the scorers on the team and considered that to be one of my strongest attributes as a player. I saw basketball as the vehicle through which I could afford to attend college. Just before my high school graduation, it was announced that my high school coach, Bob Eschenbrenner, would be assuming the head coaching position here at FSCC. I had had Coach Eschenbrenner for 3 years as a coach, and I was excited to have him for another 2 years as a coach. I had visions of continuing my status as a scorer. However, Coach called me into his office before the next season began and explained to me what my role would be on the college team. He said, "Steve, you are not going to be a scorer in college. You're going to play defense, and you're going to distribute the ball." Wow. And that came as a complete surprise to me. You see, I always thought scoring was going to be my forte. Coach said, "You will shoot when you're open, but that will not be your primary role." Initially, it was hard for me to accept that new role as defined by the coach. Soon, however, I realized the wisdom of my coach. College players were bigger, stronger, faster, and highly talented. For me to compete, I needed to embrace the new role the coach had defined for me. He knew that I could play college basketball, but not as a scorer. One of the core values here at FSCC is to promote personal success and growth by empowering students to attain their goals. This is exactly what my coach did for me, as he helped me develop a more realistic view of my basketball career. The motivational speaker Zig Ziglar once said, "What you get by achieving your goal is not as important as what you become by achieving your goal. He said that though achieving a goal is to be celebrated, the journey toward the goal will transform you into a better and matured human being. That during the journey, there will be issues, and while fixing those issues, you will learn the best teachings of life. Coach Eschenbrenner helped me develop a truer understanding of my basketball potential. He encouraged me, he corrected me, he challenged me, and he supported me. This was one of my first opportunities at FSCC to engage in self-introspection, to become more self-aware, and to increase confidence in my abilities. Let me ask you a question. Did you have a particular FSCC instructor that had a special impact on you here at FSCC during your experiences here? There were several instructors that influenced me during my 2 years at FSCC. One specific classroom experience had a lasting impact on me. Although I majored in mathematics, I minored in social science. The incident took place in a social science class taught by Marcel Norman. I had heard all about Mr. Norman. He is an excellent teacher. He is extremely demanding of his students. You need to take thorough notes during his lectures. He will give pop quizzes nearly every class period. His grade scale is high. You will learn much, but you must come to class prepared. So, when the first unit exam was announced, I spent hours and hours poring over my notes, reviewing the pages of the textbook. I came to class that day prepared and confident I was ready to do well. When I turned the test paper over and saw the first question, I was frustrated and I was angry. The first question was, who is the author of your textbook? I didn't know, and I thought to myself, who cares? When I discussed with, or maybe I should say challenged, Mr. Norman as to why this particular question was on the test in the first place, since it had absolutely nothing to do with the content of the class, he replied, Steve, your author spent hours and hours and hours researching, developing, organizing, and finally publishing material so that we could better understand the intricacies of the course. The least we can do is to show our appreciation and respect for the work he did by knowing his name. I don't know about you, but I didn't share the same enthusiasm about the author's name as Mr. Norman. But I did learn a lesson later and understand later the lesson that he wanted me to learn. And the lesson he shared through this simple gesture was this. He wanted me and the rest of his students to understand the importance of respect and integrity. These are still core values. FSCC. Both of these personal experiences remain indelibly etched in my memory. They serve as important reminders of the role that FSCC experience had in helping me to better understand my strengths and weaknesses, how to set realistic goals based on that understanding, how to recognize and appreciate the hard work of others as they attempt to broaden my knowledge and understanding, and how to interact with others with respect and kindness. As the 19th century American author Christian Bouvier once said, kindness is the language which the deaf can hear and the blind can see. As you leave here today, you can take pride in your academic achievements. You worked hard, and this commencement ceremony is a recognition of that hard work. May you continue to experience additional personal success and growth as you strive to attain your next goals, and may you always incorporate integrity, respect, and kindness throughout all your future endeavors. Congratulations to each of you, the FSCC graduating class of 2022.
And now, Holly Mason, the director of our TRIO program, will introduce the outstanding sophomore.
Good afternoon. As Alicia said, my name is Holly Mason, and I'm the director of our TRIO Student Support Services program here at Fort Scott Community College. I'm excited to introduce Daphne Hedrick, the 2022 Fort Scott Community College Outstanding Sophomore. Daphne, originally from Labette County, Kansas, was on the honor roll throughout her 4 years of high school. While a student here at Fort Scott Community College, Daphne made multiple appearances on the Vice President's honor roll. Daphne's ability to manage her academic, extracurricular, and employment responsibilities is impressive. She is the captain of the FSCC esports team, a member of TRIO, a two-time recipient of the TRIO Supplemental Scholarship, and a Phi Theta Kappa member. However, what I find most impressive about Daphne is her work ethic. She's worked four jobs simultaneously while a student here at FSCC to avoid having to take out a loan while in college. She works hard to serve others as well. On her yearly trips to Mexico, she takes clothes, hygiene products, and toys to help families that are in need. She also participates in food and clothing drives in her community and has helped with hosting gaming events and homecoming here at FSCC. Daphne is the poster child for community colleges. She's a first-generation college student from an immigrant family who is grateful for the opportunity she has received here at FSCC. She's a hard worker with a vision for her future who strategically plans her moves to be successful. Daphne plans to continue her education at Cottey College, where she will be on an esports scholarship. She intends to major in biology and is planning a career working in a zoo with exotic animals. Daphne and I bonded quickly when we met, probably because we both have this secret goal to meet every other natural redhead that we come across. Daphne's laugh is infectious, and her kind and funny personality will guarantee success in her future. Congratulations, Daphne.
Welcome, graduates, and all of your families, of course. I am just so thrilled and excited to be given the privilege to be able to speak to you here today and to receive this award. It's honestly meant a lot to me. Because of every single one of you's hard work and dedication, I am able to stand here with you as a proud Fort Scott graduate. It's honestly hard for me to believe that this day has come so quickly. It feels like yesterday I was just moving my stuff in and getting settled, and now we're here. I had actually, funnily enough, only been to Fort Scott about two or three times before moving here. But I moved my way away from my family about 2 hours, and it was pretty scary, honestly. And I know many of you have come from out of state and traveled here and made a home here for yourselves. But I knew from my first day of school when I got here that this would be my new home. I was welcomed with open arms by students and faculty alike, and I am so honored to be given that privilege. In my time here, I have made many lifelong friends, and I've made many lifelong memories. FSCC has not only helped me develop in my love for esports, it has also given me tools and knowledge that I will continue to use many years after graduating from here. And having people that greet you by name when you walk by the hallways or just actually caring about you in such a developmental part of your life is so important and such a privilege that I think is unique to FSCC. I cannot state enough how the faculty, staff, and students alike have provided a caring and loving and nurturing learning environment. I especially wanted to thank and recognize the trio ladies, Susan Benson, Coach Souza, Maria Barr, and Susie Arvidson, for always going above and beyond for every single one of the students. I also wanted to thank my mom, especially, and the rest of my family. You guys mean the absolute world to me and have supported me every single step of the way. Wouldn't have been here without you. Many of my favorite memories at Fort Scott is honestly just in the daily things that I would do. Greeting teachers in the hallways, going, hanging out in the esports room, or working on my ceramics project that I had a hate-love relationship with. and finally, guys, I just wanted to say that I know this is an end, but it is also a new beginning. Let this be the beginning in your journey of life. Let here be a time for a celebration, and let this be a stepping stone for your goals and accomplishments that are ahead of you. And to quote Corey Taylor, you have incredible lives ahead of you. You have incredible things that you can accomplish. If you feel that, you will have an amazing life. Do not let anything build a wall too tall for you to get over. You can get through it. You're stronger than you think, and you will always be stronger than you think. Feel that in your heart and do what you want. I am so grateful to be able to know every single one of you and to be standing here. And I will treasure every single memory, every single greeting in the hallway, every single funny comment in the classroom. I'm gonna remember that forever. And lastly, guys, I really just wanted to say your future is yours. You can go and accomplish amazing, wonderful things, and I believe in every single one of you. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you, Daphne. That was truly amazing. Dr. Adam Borth will now recognize our emeritus faculty.
We have two emeritus faculty this year, and we're going to do these one by one. The first would be Mrs. Kathy Malone, so I will bring her up here. Kathy has, and both of them, Mrs. Malone and Mrs. Cummings, both told me they wanted me to keep this short because this is more about the students than it is about them, so I am going to honor that request and keep it very short. Kathy has been employed at FSCC since the mid-90s, so we are losing a ton of experience with her. She is one of the best math teachers I have ever ran across in my career. She held the Math Relays Festival at the college, which would bring more students here for a math competition than I thought were interested in math in general. So that her level of dedication to the to FSCC, the college, and the students is truly one of those things that you can't even put into words. And we are honored to have Kathy be one of our emeritus faculty this year. The other individual that we have as emeritus faculty is Deb Cummings. Deb has had many roles at FSCC in her 27 years, from currently being an instructor in the department chair for business and also working within human resources as an assistant to the president and a staff accountant. Her students have had some unique experiences, been able to meet Warren Buffett a couple of different times with groups that she's taken, and she's always been an advocate for FSCC. I consider Deb to be one of the best people I have ever met. She is very kind, willing to go out of her way to help anybody, and always has a smile on her face. She is a great mentor to the students and a valuable asset, and we will miss her greatly. So, congratulations, Deb.
And I just want to say thank you for the 27 years. Thank you to the employees, the staff, the faculty that I've worked with that have blessed my life. And thank you to all the students that have passed through my doors because I've really enjoyed it. Thank you.
At the earlier ceremony, we also recognized Darlene Wood as emeritus staff. And between the three of them retiring this year, we are losing over 90 years of combined experience, which is truly amazing. Okay, so now, students and graduates, I guess, congratulations. Will the candidates for the Associate of Arts and the Associate of Science degrees please stand and remain standing? This would be all of you. Okay. President Johnston, on the recommendation of the faculty, I present these candidates for their designated degrees.
By the power vested in me by the State of Kansas and the Board of Trustees of Fort Scott Community College, I confer on you the designated degrees and certificates. Will the ushers now present the graduating class?
Daphne Marie Hedrick. Drake Garcia. Jacqueline Shea Hampton. Elizabeth Nicole Adamson. Yaria Akers. Riley Batters. Alexis Sky Bailey. Ashlyn Jade Baldridge. Ariana Tajay Baston. Angelica Bernal. Madison Bowersock. Hunter Thomas Brennan. Mia Laureen Bryant. Trey Buchanan. Kevin Carter. Kylie Hope Davis. Lucorian Gregory DeBost. Jacob B. Delatorre. Caden DeMott. Alina Gail Erie. Gabriella Fess. McKenna Diane Finley. Kara Marie Folsom. Lindsay Ann Forsbloom. Megan Foster. Allie Joe Fry. Caleb Garcia. Landry Renee George. Chance John Gurlman. Kayla Danae Gilmore. Sierra Lynn Graham. Addison Guilfoyle. Bailey Jolynn Harrison. Ryan Keith Hillman. Maya Hull. Jacqueline Celeste Ivy. Jada Jelks Browning. Lonel Johnson. Katrina Louise Sue Johnson. Jada Renee Jones. David Adam Jones. Robert Charles Kemmer. Reagan Kennan. Haven J. Kelly. Alyssa Martin. Connor Matthew Mason. Marcy Ann McDonald. Ashley Morey. Addison Dean Lyons. Annabelle Paulette Morris. Isabel Katrina Moss. Josiah Elijah Noga. Josie Parsons. Mackenzie Ivy Peoples. Kyra Leah Pryor. Samantha Renee Reagan. Matthew D. Rank. Christopher Thomas Rausch. Madison Iris Schekheis. John Simpson. Juliana Nicole Sprague. Ethne Stubbs Jr. Avery Ann Tittle. Anaya, my angel, Tab. Carly Ann Marie Studevin. Noah Van Trees. Ethan Allen Westerman. Addison Rain Williams. Mackenzie Renee Wilson. Victoria Wright. Hanok Gabra Christos. Leilani Brooks Jackson. Gudisa Adnow.
Let these last people get to their seat. And then would all the graduates please rise? You may now move your tassels to the left. And at this time, I present to you the 2022 graduating class of Fort Scott Community College. Congratulations, guys. The stage party will leave, and then the graduates, and so please remain standing until all the graduates have left the auditorium. Thank you.
Thank you.